Hi, my name is Tyler, and this is Aftertouch Audio. I just finished setting up this beautiful 5.1 mixing template, and I thought I'd show you guys a system I've implemented in this template to help my music and dialogue tracks sit together better. If you like what I do and would like to support the channel, consider liking, commenting, and subscribing. And if you'd like to support me further, consider checking out my SFX shop over at aftertouchaudio.com. For mixing music and dialogue together, I use manual volume automation and reverb to mix. I also have a custom sidechain setup using Fabfilter Pro C2 and Fabfilter Pro Q3. The goal of this setup is to duck mid-frequencies in the music track when the dialogue comes in and reduce the volume of the music track just before the dialogue comes in. Let's start with Pro Q3. In Pro Q3, you can set up frequency bands that react with the input of another audio's channel. In this case, it's going to be the dialogue. To set the system up in Cubase, load an instance of Fabfilter Pro Q3 on your music bus and enable the sidechain input at the top of the plugin. Then, under your dialogue track, select the sends and select Fabfilter Pro Q3. From there, we can load in a frequency band by double-clicking, set the frequency band somewhere around the 600Hz range, and then widen the queue. To make this band react to your dialogue track, you'll need to click and drag the outer ring of the gain knob and drag it up or down. This will turn that frequency band into a dynamic band. From there, you'll need to select the auto button and click the external sidechain button, and then adjust your threshold accordingly. The threshold will basically control how quickly the EQ will duck or boost your frequencies. Okay, now that that's set up, let's move on to Pro C2. Pro C2 is a little easier to set up, but it uses the exact same starting setup. Click the sidechain button at the top of the plugin to enable the send, go to your dialogue track, and send the dialogue track to Pro C2. When we return to Pro C2, we can click the big sidechain button. Or you might have done it before. Live on the edge a little. Once that is done, a little drop-down menu will appear with a few extra options. To start, I like to roll off the low end so the low end doesn't influence the gain reduction at all. After that is done, you'll need to select the external input, and the dialogue should now be ducking the music track. For the compression settings, I usually turn on a max look ahead, increase the attack and release so it's a softer reduction, and then play with the threshold until I get the amount of gain reduction I'm looking for. I also go ahead and turn off automatic gain compensation, for obvious reasons. When I'm mixing, I will automate the thresholds, volume, and reverb settings, but this system really helps me get closer to a polished sound. Now go make some noise!